So one of the first things I want to do is add a button right here that plays some audio. Let me drag out the utility area and then go find the button and then drag that onto the canvas here. Now I'm going to change the image of this button in a little bit. But before I do that, I want to think about where I'm going to write the code that will execute when I press this button. In essence, where do I write the action for this button using the control drag technique? Let's think about how we did that for the stop button in the previous scene. I'm going to select this scene and then go to the assistant editor. So you may recall that we control dragged from this stop button to this file, viewController.swift, and created an action called stop audio. So what we need to do now is create a new view controller for this second scene in our app. All right, to do that, I will first manage some screen space by going back to the standard editor. Then I will go to the file menu at the top, click on new, and then create a new file. Here under iOS on the left, I will select a Coco Touch class and then click next. I will call this class PlaySoundsViewController. Now this is going to be a subclass of UIViewController because we want to inherit methods like viewDidLoad, etc. Our language is still Swift, and I will hit next. And I will save this new class in the same folder as my app and hit create. All right, so we now have a new file called PlaySoundsViewController.swift with a class by the same name inside it. So the next thing to do here is to go back to the storyboard and connect this second scene in our app here to the new file that we just made. So I will select this second scene and then open the utilities tray. In here under Identity Inspector, you will notice that the current view controller is this guy, UI view controller. I can substitute this with Play Sounds view controller. And as I start typing, Xcode auto completes it for me. All right, so let's make the action for this button now. I can go to the assistant editor, and on the left here, I see my storyboard. And on the right, I see the view controller that this scene is associated with, which is the new file we created, PlaySoundsViewController.swift. If I go to my first scene, you will notice that the view controller on the right-hand side of the screen changes, which is ViewController.swift. So I can hop back and forth between my first scene and the second scene in the app, and the view controller for it changes automatically. The reason why that happens is because we have this automatic setting selected over here. All right, now we can create an action for this button in this new view controller.